floods, fires, storm and tree damage, sinkholes, mold, and many other disasters that you need to know about, how to prevent and prepare for them, as well as what to do when it happens and what to expect after it happens. This is Damage Control, Tuesdays at 10:30, right here on The Source.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Back with Daniel Hightower. See if I can say it right this time. Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer fighting for active, I can't see the other part now, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. Mary Shelton, could you help me out here a little bit? Could use a little help. We were talking about lawsuits and about PIP and et cetera with Dan earlier. And, you know, there have been so many ridiculous lawsuits people bring. Some of them people just get crazy with these, some of these suits, but some of the ones that I remember, among others, are this the McDonald's hot coffee thing, and they won a big claim for that, didn't they? The woman did.
Won a big jury verdict.
Yeah, a jury verdict. Yeah,
over $2 million, yeah. But the judge dramatically reduced it, and entered judgment for the reduced amount, and then. There was an appeal, and ultimately it was settled. And that was an aberrant verdict. I mean, buddy, here's what I want to remind you and everybody listening, and that is thousands of lawsuits are tried every day all across this great land, all 50 states. You know, everybody's got a county. Everybody's got a county courthouse. There are people running stop signs and turning left in front of, and running red lights and hurting people that are driving down the road, minding their own business, following the laws. And we as lawyers try to, when we're representing the injured people that were driving lawfully, we try to resolve those cases out of court. Don't even file a lawsuit. Just write the insurance company and say, look, I represent so-and-so. Your insured ran a stop sign, caused a crash. Here's the crash report. Here's the medical records. Here's what the doctor says about my client's injuries. He couldn't work for this period of time. He required this much medical treatment, medical bills. Going to require some in the future. This is what we want to resolve the case for. And, you know, probably 75-80% of the time, I would expect that those claims like that are resolved in direct negotiations between me, the lawyer for the injured person, and the insurance adjuster.
Never goes to court. And they have a set amount they know that for certain accidents they're going to have to probably pay.
Exactly.
And you know what that number is,
yes.
Too.
Well, we have the insurance industry, when I work for them, mm-hmm. they have a database, just like anybody, yeah. almost any business or industry, and they keep track of verdicts in Florida and probably every other state in the union. lawyers like me, we have a jury verdict service periodical that tells us what's going on with jury verdicts statewide and similar, and a little summary of the facts. So we get an idea of values. Values are set by what juries put on a case after they hear both sides. And but back to what I was saying a minute ago, I just want to remind people, first of all, we have a very sound civil justice system here in America. It's the best in the world. It's not perfect because it was thought up by humans and it's administered by humans, and we all know humans are imperfect. There's only one perfect being. So it's not the perfect system, but if you do any study of justice systems around the world, other countries, you will come back and say, we have the best system in the world.
I don't want those guys with long wigs, four or five of them are in there. Makes me nervous.
Here's the important thing. Thousands of cases that aren't settled are tried all every little county courthouse all across America every day, every week, every month. How often do you hear about a McDonald's coffee cup case in the newspaper? What, once a month, once every 6 months, once a year? So what that tells me, and what it should reassure you and other listeners, is that 99.9% of the time the civil justice system works, the result expected happens, and it's not newsworthy.
Mm.
It's what everybody expected.
Yeah, the ones that don't make the paper.
You know, right.
The settle out of court part, yeah. Which is not, and doesn't take the time up for the judge.
And, you know, I did, and some people say, well, these injury claims and lawsuits and frivolous things, I think they're clogging up the court system. I contacted David Elsterman, our clerk of court, because I knew just of general information that the majority of the cases in our court system in Marin County were not injury claims. Actually, the majority of them are, ready for this, doesn't surprise you, criminal cases, okay? Adult and juvenile, all right? Followed by civil cases, foreclosures, divorce cases, consumer debt cases, landlord-tenant cases, bankruptcy cases, those are federal, but in our state courts, the other ones I mentioned, and then there are civil cases, and less than 10% of the civil cases filed are injury cases.
Really?
So it's a very small percentage.
I would never have guessed that.
Yeah, and I've got David Elsterman was kind enough to print out a clerk of court data sheet and give it to me.
How about that David Elsterman coming through like that?
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Good man.
He's a good
guy. Yeah.
And there's the annual report from 2010.
Yeah.
So
a myth that lawyers are always chasing amicus and creating is clog up the court systems with these cases about accident victims.
The myth is perfect, people, when you see all this, and this is another thing that people ask me about, what about all this advertising, all these billboards and all these TV ads, what are these, they just look like they're chasing ambulances and trying to get money and everything. Well, first of all, I say, look, this is America. We have this thing called the First Amendment. It's called freedom of expression, freedom of speech, and it's protected.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that some lawyers advertise and it irritates you, I can understand that. It irritates me. But there's some other commercials that I watch on TV at night that irritate me, like all the insurance company commercials over and over and over again.
Gonna fire that shot across the
like mouth. The Cialis commercial over and over and over again.
That's the one that just annoys me.
I mean, yeah. But the fact that commercials are irritating sometimes is, that's a personal.
But how do we know how to get a lawyer? I mean, I don't know. I mean, other than ask your friends.
Yeah.
You say, can you give me a couple? If I'm new in town, I need someone to do this. What do you have to ask? I mean, at least advertising gives me an idea.
Yes, it does. If somebody asked me, what's the best way to get a lawyer? Of course, if you're new in town, I think you should ask your friends, your relatives, your neighbors, if you got a doctor or or somebody did your will, ask them. You know, word of mouth is always good. You know, the Yellow Pages give you some information on qualifications. Websites.
Yep, new thing now. We get
websites. It's like Yellow Pages on steroids. It's just full of information that you can't afford to put in Yellow Pages.
But you can't get recommendations. That's what I want for my friends and people that I work with. Give me a recommendation.
Yes.
Because I don't know. There are 10 people. Which one's the best one? You know.
Yeah.
We only got about a minute. I want to get this in real quick for you. Thank you for all that information. And thanks to David Ellsberg for doing that work. I want to get this question, as we got about a minute to answer it. Why did you decide to become a lawyer?
Okay, well, if we only have a minute, then I want to use part of it to say that I am honored to be on this show.
Oh, you
okay? Because I will probably never be in the presence of a Pulitzer Prize finalist again and the author of 7 books. I got to tell you, buddy,
man.
I'm impressed. And,
and
I'm honored you invited me on the show.
I'm impressed and I'm honored you're here. So, you like that. So, and by the way, now you got an extra minute.
Okay. Why did I want to become a lawyer? Well, it was interesting when I was in college, I thought I wanted to be an orthodontist, but then I ran into calculus and organic chemistry and we just didn't hit it off too well. So I switched over to history, and my mother used to tell me as a child, she said, "Son, you argue a lot. You ought to be a lawyer." So it may be a self-fulfilling prophecy.
Mothers are always right, aren't they?
Yeah, they're always right. But I've enjoyed it, and it's a service industry. You know, we help people. Not all of them are the most likable people, but, you know, they're American citizens. They have rights. They have responsibilities. And whether they're somebody like you or me, they're all covered by the same United States Constitution, and that's something I take very seriously.
No, you do.
Yeah.
You know, it's funny. We all have our jokes about lawyers and other people, professions, but lawyers, but yet when you need one, they are really good to have.
Yes.
You don't realize how much you appreciate them until you need one. So.
Yeah. Well, some people are kind of insensitive about other people in accidents with injuries. But, you know, once you're in an accident and you suffer the upheaval in your life, you've lost your transportation, you may have lost, you're out of work, you're hurting, you're irritable, it creates problems in the family, the children, the spouse are affected. It's a life-changing event, and unless you've gone through it, it's easy to be insensitive about it. But if you go through it, you it'll create a whole new sensitivity.
And now I know what the slogan really means when you say fighting for accident victim justice since 1976, because you really mean it, don't you?
Yes, I really do.
I like that word fight again there. Yeah. Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer. Daniel, it's been great to have you on. Will you come back?
Absolutely. I enjoyed it.
And bring Mary Shelton when you come,
too.
Okay.
I will.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, buddy.
We'll take a break. Come back. We have tweets and quotes. Finish up this hour. Then we got sports coming up on Buddy Sports page at 5 o'clock. Stay tuned to the voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, the source.
Recently, I had a great conversation with General Manager Pat Murray on the special events at Country Club of Ocala.
We have a lot of special events here that are geared towards the family. Easter comes to mind. We have an Easter bunny who hops around on the driving range. We usually hide somewhere in a neighborhood of 3,000 eggs and turn them loose and let them go harvest the eggs. We have a great family celebration here on the 4th of July where it's a traditional cookout, if you will. And as the sun goes down, the driving range becomes alive with probably one of the better fireworks displays in the area. Breakfast with Santa is a big deal.
Country Club of Ocala, where the Easter Bunny, Santa, and all the children, large and small, are a big deal on every special occasion. For more information, call 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of the Bundy Gator Report, right here on The Source.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Jerry Ferris Finger, a journalist and editor retired from the Atlanta Journal-Constitution and coming up to speak to us about the book The Devil Laughed, a Mariah Drew Richard Lake mystery novel.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events served bite-sized.
And then Hank Whittier will be in the studio bringing you veterans news as he does each and every Thursday.
August Turek is the founder of Raleigh Group International and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal, Forbes, and Business Week. He's written a book called Business Secrets of the Monks, one CEO's quest for meaning and authenticity.
And then Linda Gygax, Susan Smith, Nancy Porter, and Lois Lane will be in the studio talking to us about the 2013 charity fundraising event.
Melanie Gideon and Staff Sergeant Brian Schieffer will be on the phone. They will be speaking about the UCLA Operation Men, helping heal America's wounded warriors.
All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Got a couple minutes to go here on the program. We're going to get to tweets and quotes in 1 second. If you haven't heard Daniel Hightower in my brain. The news is Johnny Manziel is sitting out half a game. JJ laughs.
30 minutes, buddy.
30 minutes of time
for
making about 25 games. No, I'm just making that up. So, yeah, that's interesting. We'll see. It was obviously a plea bargain. Getting to that in the sports, we've got plenty of time to do that. We also got Mark Long talking about a situation in Gainesville and talking about the opening game against Toledo on Saturday. Gators kicking it off at around 12 on Saturday from up in Gainesville. And Florida State Seminoles playing on Monday night. Game week. Carried right here on our station. And we've got North Marion High School at Forest with the two Toms on the call. So stay tuned for that. Let's roll that music up. A little tweets and quotes time. And we need to hear a little tweet from that music, Gary, on this Wednesday afternoon. Rather toasty outside today. This comes from Benjamin Disraeli. Experience is the child of thought. And thought is the child of action. Mae West once said, it's not the men in your life that matters, it's the life in your men. And finally, on this day when remembering Martin Luther King's famous speech of 50 years ago, this comes from the philosopher Goethe. To think is easy. To act is hard, but the hardest thing in the world is to act in accordance with your thinking. last line was, act in accordance with your thinking. To finish that thought up. Okay, also some news about Gator basketball players being suspended the first three games. We'll check with all that information as well. And take a look at the baseball scores. My Rays are kind of slipping and sliding, JJ.
Yes.
Three in a row. They got beat, lost a heartbreaker last night. Uncustomable for them to blow a lead like that, and that Fernando Rodney getting tapped like he did, and them losing that game in the final inning. So all that coming your way next right here on the program called Buddy Sports Page on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Indiana town, had a good looking mom. She never was around, but she grew up tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
Wowzers! July sales were unusually great and we weren't prepared for it. Now we need cars quick to restock our lot.
Hey, this is Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I've cooked up a crazy idea that can help you stop driving a car you hate and help me get cars now.
It's a car bazaar. It's weird, wild, and worth the trip.
It's more fun than a flea market.
And there are more deals than a dollar store. So bring that old car you hate driving to our car bazaar.
Even if you owe way more than it's worth?
Yes, and get a lot more than appraised value.
Even if your credit is good or bad?
Yes, with our For the People credit approval process, we want to help you stop driving a car you hate today.
The bazaar ends after we've helped 37 people find a car they love. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige!
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
This is WOCA, News Talk 1370.
So what did you do with your weekend? Me? I was flying, because I'm taking flying lessons from Ocala Aviation. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, hey, I'd like to give that a shot, but I'm not quite sure. Well, I've got the solution. It's called the Discovery Flight, and that's exactly what it is. It helps you discover the wonder of flying and if it's for you. It's only $99, and it gives you the chance to learn a bit more about the airplane and then actually go for a ride with a flight instructor and take control of the airplane. That's how I got started, and now I'm on my way to being a pilot. I know, scary thought, right? But the demand for qualified pilots is stronger than ever. And with the help of Ocala Aviation, you could make a career change and learn to be a commercial pilot. But it all starts with a discovery flight. So stop by the flight school, conveniently located at the Ocala Airport. Visit the website at ocalaaviation.com or call 861-7484. That's 861-7484. Ocala Aviation. Your adventure starts here.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440 or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
WOCA, Ocala. You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
ABC News Now, I'm Daria Albinger. This is a reason that you may want to limit your alcohol consumption. Researchers at Washington and Harvard University say women who drink regularly between the time of their first period and when they have their first baby may be an increased risk for breast cancer and benign breast disease, too. 50 years after Martin Luther King urged Americans to let freedom ring, bells rung out in the nation's capital and across the country, too. President Obama, the nation's first black president, told a crowd of thousands at the Lincoln Memorial, Dr. King's dream is still alive. So your credit has a few dings, but you need a new car? Make sure you don't get yo-yoed. It's a scam that's become more common among some dealers. They let a customer leave with a car before the financing is finalized. Then the customer's told there's a problem, but it can be fixed for a fee, of course. You can't finance love or happiness, but an economics professor at Chapman University in California says money can encourage cooperation and trust among strangers. This is ABC News.
Come on, sweetie, jump to dad.
I'm not sure, Daddy. The water's cool.
There are moments in life that cause us to hesitate.
Jump right here.
Okay. Here I come.
I got you. Good job.
I did it. That was fun.
But once we take action, we're really glad that we did. If you're thinking about selling your home, don't hesitate. Interest rates are low and buyers are in the market. Every market's different. Call a Realtor today and visit Realtor.com. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
In mid-sized companies, the left hand needs to know what the right hand is doing. When they do, business can take on a whole new rhythm, especially with IBM Smart Cloud Engage Advanced. It combines communities, web meetings, and file sharing with business-grade email in one security-rich environment, making it the smarter way to collaborate. Register now for your 60-day free trial at ibm.com/engines/engage.
How much time? 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho.
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
For us to get involved there and get our opening going today. At least we're on the air here. We're progressing as we go along.
Doing a lot better in this hour than you were the first hour.
Yeah, this is.
I was running the board.
Yeah, well, you know, you're a rookie.
Rookie.
Yeah. So this is called Buddy Sports Page. On a Wednesday today on the program, we've got some news about Johnny Manziel, which we'll tell you about in just a moment. You know by now, he's going to serve a short suspension. We'll get more details of that. So you just got the headlines completely. Coming up in the program, Mark Long from the Associated Press will be on the program today to talk about the Gators' opening game against Toledo. We'll talk about who this team is and what they do and what their strengths are, and also talk about an incident that happened up there, which was quite moving, I thought. Something that one player did on behalf of another and for a good humane cause. And three players suspended by Billy Donovan for the first three games. I'll give you their names as well. But first, JJ in the headlines.
Johnny Football. Definitely close number two today, but Johnny Manziel today. Suspended for 30 minutes of live football action, buddy. The first half of the Rice game, so that means he will be eligible to play in the biggest game of the year against Alabama in the week after that. So the NCAA and Texas A&M sort of came to an agreement. Like you said, it was a plea deal, basically, and he took it. Only 30 minutes of football. Today, a report came out that Aaron Hernandez was using PCP and could have been paranoid at the time of the Odin Lloyd murder.
Yeah, it's actually it's a tease to a story that's coming out in Rolling Stone.
Right.
And talk about him taking angel dust, but it's just a tease. It doesn't give you the full facts of the story.
I saw him on Dan Patrick today.
Saw who?
The writer of the story.
Oh, you didn't see Aaron Hernandez on Dan Patrick?
No, he didn't make an appearance.
Is he a fugitive from justice?
Yeah.
And the biggest non-news story of the week, who's starting quarterback for the Washington Redskins?
There we go, RG3 to start opener, buddy.
Please.
So he hasn't played all preseason, won't play the last preseason game, but he should be able to play the Monday night opener against the Philadelphia Eagles on ESPN. And last night, Chiray's lost. Blown save by Fernando Rodney. 6-5 loss to the Angels last night, buddy.
Yeah, they were leading going into the final inning, too. And there was and they made errors, which they never do, by the way. Jennings dropped one in midfield. And Fernando Rodney walked the opening batter, you know. And so just things they didn't usually do. And they've won almost every tight game. It's amazing how many close games. Last night, the Rays losing their third in a row, which is a little disturbing. 2.5 out now in the American League East. And so it better not be a trend. So,
buddy, I've been watching Twitter to see the results of Johnny Manziel's sentence hand down. SportsCenter tweeted this: agreement between NCAA and Texas A&M to suspend Johnny Manziel closes the book on the matter. Mm-hmm. Then you got Ira Schofield, who is a friend of the show here.
Tallahassee Democrat.
Right. Manziel suspended for half, huh? So the NCAA officially has only slightly more muscle than a parking lot attendant. Then Deion Sanders. Mm-hmm. Here's what Deion Sanders had to say. Congrats, Johnny. You're a smart man. You signed a lot of stuff, but you didn't sign a prenup, so you got a half. And then finally, Jay Manziel 2, Johnny Manziel's official Twitter site. Here's what he wrote about an hour ago. I ain't perfect. I ain't insane, but I am worth it. If there's one thing I am, it's worth it. People keep hating, but it ain't working.
What does that even mean?
Okay, now he's doing rap music or what?
Somebody needs to take his Twitter away from him.
Yeah, well, here's the deal. And I really was going to wait to get into the story a little later because it takes a little thought. And in the opening segment, it's hard to do that. I'm working on this piece I've been working on for a month about a crisis in college football, which I got finished. As I was thinking about it today, I wrote this paragraph that there's no way in the world that the NCAA – will bite the hand that feeds it, that Johnny Moneymaker, as I call him now, would be not playing in not only the game of the year, but maybe the game of the decade when the Crimson Tide rolls into College Station, by the way, back-to-back national champions, ranked number one, to play against the Texas Aggies. There's no way he won't play in that game. And this is the hypocrisy of the NCAA. We all knew it. We just didn't know how to get out of it. Obviously, a plea bargain. And I don't guess Manziel, we'll find out the details of the story during the break. I don't guess he ever actually admitted it, but they both winked at it and moved on. And you know what? I hate to say this, I kind of agree with it.
Yeah, I'm happy this.
You know, I mean, it's a terrible thing to think that we think that way, but this is what it is. The whole nature of the game has changed. It's a different kind of thing, and we have to embrace that because, let's face it, there's the other side of this deal too about players not getting being able to use their celebrity for their own good, and who owns that celebrity. And there's the irony of the fact we're talking about players with underprivileged backgrounds not needing money to be able to buy a pizza on the weekends. Here's a guy who's a rich kid. He's a rich kid, and the fact he doesn't need the money. So now you got the opposite. What do you do with a rich kid who doesn't need the money and kind of is just going his own way and can kind of do what he wants to do in a way? So
my problem is tattoos and jerseys get you suspended and your team not able to play for a national championship, but signing autographs for money gets you 30 minutes.
They had a confession. And they had the goods. The NC2A did not have the confession, did not have the goods. They had no proof. So they got gave him a hand slap.
Danny Cannell said, in his opinion, the NCAA should have dropped the hammer or done nothing. This compromise is insulting to everyone's intelligence.
They did nothing. So there you go. But you're not going to make the guy sit out. And he's not going to sit out and miss the game while they're right down to the side.
They're not going to miss that Alabama payday
either. Of course they're not going to. So what do you do? And I said, I hate to say it, but I think it's the right decision. I think they might have maybe suspended it for a whole game. Might have looked a little bit better.
Yeah.
I think they'd be able to handle Rice without
it. That's so stupid.
But what do they do? What do they do now with the University of Miami?
Who knows? Who knows what they've got on
the University of Miami? They don't have any proof except for Nevin Shapiro.
They got a lot of receipts.
But you see, they got Nevin Shapiro, and they don't even have that in the Manziel case. So they have no proof. Anyway, let's take the break, come back, and we'll talk to Mark Long about it. I want to mention three players suspended by Billy Donovan will miss the first three games. Casey Prather is the biggest name in this group. Casey, of course, has been a regular and played for Donovan for a couple of years. He's one of the better players they've got. Then they've got Devontae Harris and Dorian Finney-Smith, two newcomers who also suspended, will miss three games. No big deal because they're all meaningless games, but that's the news on Gator basketball. So thanks to Franz Beard for checking with us on that. We will take a break. We'll return. We'll talk to Mark Long. We'll discuss more. Let's discuss the fact about Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow keeps making the cut, and he's got the number one guy rooting for him. We'll tell you about that next right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, the source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's
leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
WOCA.
Universal Soil Solutions continues its quest to bring remediation through education to Marion County. Our staff is located in the Paddock Mall Center Court and ready to answer all of your sinkhole questions. Know the facts when it comes to protecting and preserving your structure. Be smart, get educated. Knowledge is only potential power. Take action. Let us educate you so you'll be confident in your decision making. Visit our kiosk and ask us how our business cards can be worth $1,000. We are your sinkhole solution. Universal Soil Solutions, where integrity meets trust. Call 877-519-2777 for additional information.
Howdy folks, RL here to invite you to Dairy Queen for a great new meal. Dairy Queen's now serving three different $5 meals. Hot dogs, chili, cheese, slaw, whatever. Quarter pound with cheese, loaded up any way you like it. Solid filet chicken tenders. And each meal comes with fries, a drink, and a sundae for only $5. You got that right. Nobody beats that deal. A great value and a great meal. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's ocalaforsale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. ocalaforsale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to ocalaforsale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, less proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information-hungry, better-educated, high-income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
This Johnny Manziel story, I know that you don't want to get into it too much, doesn't want to go away, but the fact that after he gets handed this light slap on the wrist, that he's tweeting that he's worth it. If there's anything he is, he's worth it. Somebody needs to grab this kid by the head and say, you know what you need instead of a slap on the wrist, a slap upside the head. I think, though, that Nick Saban might tell his defense that that's what needs to happen against Alabama, J.J. They might need to give him a slap upside the head. Austin, you're 18. You're only 2 years younger than Johnny Manziel. Is he a little out of control with his tweets that he's putting out there right after the NCAA sanctions him?
I definitely think so. I mean, if you could choose one thing that he shouldn't do is go out and gallivant on Twitter and tweet something like that.
After the NCAA sanctions him and slaps him on the wrist at best, and then him going out there just slapping the NCAA in the face saying, I'm worth it. I may be in a lot of things, but one thing I am is I'm worth it. Buddy, am I just wrong? Am I too old? Is that what it is? I'm just surly and that's just how kids are?
All the above. All the above. You would have been the guy back in when Joe Namath was like he was back in the day. You'd be the guy who would be saying, get that kid off the street, this Bachelor of Three stuff. He should be banned from football. You know, and he was the anti-hero to kids back in those days, as was Muhammad Ali. And Manziel is kind of that same figure to the people of his generation. Am I saying it's okay? No. The other thing is, keep in mind, it isn't like he took money under the table from a booster here. You know, it's not like he robbed a bank or got held up a 7-Eleven store or that he was giving large amounts of cash by somebody. He did something that we kind of all know. He got some money out of the signing. I don't know how much it was. Maybe it's $3,000 or $5,000. But he obviously covered it up pretty well. Shouldn't have done it. But they can't prove it. And is it the right thing to do? No. But But when you really sit down and think about it and you ask yourself the question, who owns Johnny Manziel's autograph, his signature, who owns his likeness, why should Texas A&M and all of college football make millions and millions and millions on him, his image, and others? And in the end, it is sort of ironic that we come down to this. It wouldn't be a felony in terms of infractions, you know, in the NCAA. It wouldn't be anything as serious that we would blow up what is going to be the biggest game of the year and one which college football is going to reap millions for because of a kid who did something that was foolish. Am I excusing it away? No, I'm not. Am I saying it's okay? No, I'm not. I'm just talking the reality of the situation. When are we going to be able to figure out a way to legislate and adjudicate these situations? Because it certainly is not fair. It's not fair to Terrell Pryor and people at Ohio State or A.J. Green at Georgia or whoever, people who serve suspensions for doing less things, for selling your jerseys and what have you. Look, it's been going on since the beginning of football. People have been doing this kind of thing, you know, 50, 60, 70 years ago. And it's going to go on continue. It happens to be Johnny Manziel, who, by the way, in my opinion, is now the most famous college football player ever. And it's going to happen to him again. So what do you do? The kid was a freshman, redshirt freshman. He came out of nowhere and wound up winning the Heisman Trophy, and Texas A&M had a great season. And let me tell you something. You think Georgia fans are crazy or LSU fans? Aggie fans were already nuts before this happened. And now think where they are. They're building a stadium over 103,000 they're going to expand it to. Texas A&M has gone ballistic. So anyway, I think it's a situation where, let's just say it's unfortunate. It is what it is. And I'm glad he's playing in the game. I think there needs to be a change in college football. And that's really what it's about. About the change in college football. It's all happening. There is a crisis in the game. We can't figure out what to do with the millions of dollars that we get. And unfairly, people are making large amounts of monies on kids who are working for nothing. And yeah, I know they get a scholarship, but still, the fact is, if they were in show business, they'd make millions. So there's something out of kilter here. And with ESPN pouring more and more and more money into it, we talked about the New York Times story saying that they basically run college football now. It's coming down to the division of the haves and have-nots, where you're going to have the division of the elite schools, 50, 60 schools, who make all the money, and then let some of it trickle down to the next group and have the major playoff. And there's going to come a day when, and I wrote about this in my piece, when that day is going to be there, when suddenly before the national championship game, after eight teams are played in the playoff and two teams, let's just say Oregon and Ohio State, are playing undefeated for the national championship on $1 billion worth of revenue, that the players one day are going to say, we're not kicking it off, see my lawyer, till we have an agreement. And they got the ultimate, and it's just what's going to happen. It's just, you can look at, I mean, this is what happens in revolutions. Tom, you're a historian. This is what happens when too many people get the gold.
Right.
There's a revolution.
Well, let me ask you this. How long is it before this is an ESPN 30 for 30 story, the Johnny Manziel saga? Are they filming it now as we speak?
Oh, yeah. I mean, look, of all the people, you know, you thought the Tim Tebow thing was crazy. I mean, yesterday's frenzy with Johnny Manziel was crazy. I mean, he must have mentioned his name 1,000 times, yet they never talked to anybody who would give any information. But they just kept saying over and over again, Johnny Manziel, Johnny Manziel, Johnny Manziel. The real inequity here is others who have had to suffer because of this, and others have. And I have a friend of mine who just texted me, what about Jim Tressel? Do they owe him an apology? Jim Tressel went down.
I think
down.
They do.
You know, he lost his job over some of the thing. And yet the SEC and others winked at the whole thing with at Auburn. You know, what was going on there before that game. So, I mean, it's the inconsistency of the NCAA. The large amounts of money are going to create change in college football, a game that I so dearly love.
Funny you should say that. I just read a tweet just a few minutes ago that said, is that Cam Newton I saw that just winked at Johnny Manziel?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So, I mean, it's changing. And, you know, and the NCAA, who contrary to what we think, is not just a bunch of rogues and terrible people. They're trying to do the right thing. They've reached a level of incompetency, however, and they've reached a situation that is unmanageable, that they don't know what to do about it. What would you do? You guys are sitting in judgment right now. You, based on what you know, what you think you know about Manziel, and you know you want to do the right thing, and yet at the same time you don't want to destroy the game. Pretend like we're all Supreme Court judges. It's before you now. You have reason to believe that Manziel took money for these autograph signings. You have to make a decision about him playing or not playing, suspended or not suspended, being kicked out or not kicked out. What is your decision?
There's no proof. It was all probably cash. There's no proof of it. So Johnny Manziel, being that he's the meal ticket of the NCAA and I'm in charge of the meal ticket, he's playing. I don't even know that I'm suspending him half a game.
I might say one game. I thought one game might have been legit. Just because it is Rice, they're going to beat him anyways. A half really looks like nothing at all. One game at least would be something. You know, that's a 10th of their season, 11th of their season, whatever it is, sort of a big deal.
JJ, and you of all people, a bitter Miami fan, where you've been sitting around waiting for how many years for the NCAA to
Eight.
Make a decision?
11, I think. Maybe even 12.
On the Miami situation, what's going to happen there, and being scared to death every time you hear something that's going to happen, the hammer's going to come down.
Right.
So, you know, is that inequity with other schools?
But I understand Johnny Football is a moneymaker. Miami is not that anymore.
By the way, he's not Johnny Football.
Johnny Moneymaker is a moneymaker.
Correct. Johnny Moneymaker is what his name is now from now on.
If, the Hurricanes have been going 11-1, 12-0 winning national titles, this might be a little bit different. But they're struggling.
Austin, what do you think?
I think one game. I'm with JJ because I think a half kind of sounds a little bit ridiculous. But
against Rice. I mean, that sounds like the ultimate insult to our intelligence. A half a game against Rice,
The ultimate insult would have been whatever 1AA school they're playing at the end of the year. We're going to wait until then we're going to set Johnny a half.
But just the sound of it, a half a game against Rice.
Yeah, 30 minutes.
Sounds like a recipe, like a half a cup of rice or something.
You know, put the rice on and half an hour later you're ready.
Exactly. It's crazy. So, but anyway, so it's something to talk about. We got big football weekend coming up. We talked about it. I'm really looking forward to that Carolina. The game starts 6, by the way. In fact, Austin, pull up those times. That game, the Battle of the Carolinas, starts at 6 tomorrow night. Now, we got like 3 or 4 of the games on that night. Poor
Tom James.
Poor Tom James trying to find his beloved USC team who are playing in Hawaii at
11
at 3 o'clock in the morning or something.
Let's start at 6 tomorrow.
Yeah, it starts
at 6. Disappointing.
Well, we'll catch it. Put your DVR on, JJ, and you'll catch it after the show. We'll be able to see it. We'll watch it. Looking forward to that game. And then, of course, we got it's a really good Saturday. You know, it's a really good Saturday. I'm really looking forward to Georgia-Clemson on Saturday, too. You guys got one
awesome.
Saturday?
That's the best one.
Yeah.
Georgia-Clemson, LSU-TCU is pretty good. Pretty,
not pretty good. It's very good.
Yeah. Florida-Toledo is a huge game.
For sure.
Huge. To see if Toledo can cover.
Do you know anything about Toledo whatsoever?
That they cover every time they play.
They're a very good offensive team, by the way. Last year, they had one of the top offenses in the MAC. And by the way, you laugh at the MAC. MAC's got some pretty decent personnel in there. And there's a running back named David Fluellen. He ranked 8th in the FBS with 1,498 yards rushing. And he scored 13 touchdowns. So, look, I'm not building them up into some powerhouse. But occasionally you get one of these games where a MAC team will cause you a problem or two, you know? And if the offense is out of sync, and I have no reason to think it isn't, you know it's going to have – because I got freshman wide receivers, you know? I think the big thing will be whether Florida's defense can dominate Toledo. You know, I'm thinking this defense might be a little better than what we think it is. They got some players over there, man. I'm telling you what, they got some talent over that side of the ball. And they're kind of a team that could stifle somebody if they want to. Now, they'll be showing vanilla, Tom. They won't be showing their whole defensive package of blitzes and whatever because they don't do that in early games. But this defense is really going to be good. And that's why I told you. You guys asked me the other day, Tuesday, about who won the SEC.
You were really conflicted.
I haven't ruled out Florida. I just have it now, but I know the popular choice is South Carolina or Georgia, and I don't I'm not ready to pull the trigger on Florida just yet. But I'm just saying, it's early. We don't know what we really got here. Freshmen can come in and change the whole landscape. Look at Manziel from last year. We might not even know the name of the Heisman Trophy winner for this year, and so it's hard to say. I think Lou Holtz said it best. He said, it's not a matter of a team changing from month to month or season to season. It's a matter of a team changing from day to day. And the team that starts on Saturday can be a totally different team the next week. And that's what you have to watch in college football if you're watching for trends. We're waiting for Mark Long from the Associated Press to join us on the program, talk football. JJ, we can talk about some baseball after the break as well, if you'd like. Catch us up on the stand. We're getting into September now. It's time for pennant races.
We got to start talking about the EPL, too. I mean, come on. Liverpool had a big game Saturday. We need to.
I'm sorry. I thought you said EPL.
I did. English Premier League. Come on, buddy.
Is that something you
get coached up?
Go to the doctor's office. You have your EPL checked or something.
You got to get coached up on the English Premier League, buddy.
I think I'll let JJ take care of that. So, all right, we'll take a break. We'll return to Buddy's Sports Page. We'll tell you about this Rolling Stone bombshell. Well, that's what they say. It's a bombshell.
I guess.
They implicated Urban Meyer somehow or another, tried to connect Urban Meyer with Hernandez, and I don't know.
It's ridiculous.
Let's see. We'll just see what they got. And I'll tell you what they said. They don't have the story out yet. This is just a promotion they're doing on their story in Rolling Stone. We'll tell you about that next right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Having the motivation and making the commitment to quit smoking is a great first step towards becoming smoke-free. However, anyone who's tried to quit smoking knows how challenging it can be. Having the determination to quit may not be enough. You may need some help. If you're ready to quit smoking and are between the ages of 18 and 75, currently smoke 10 or more cigarettes a day, and can commit to participating for 24 weeks, you may be interested in a research study which is being conducted to evaluate the use of investigational drugs to see if they can aid individuals in their quest to quit smoking. To help you quit, smoking cessation counseling and all study-related medical care will be provided at no extra cost. You may also be reimbursed for your travel time. To receive more information about this study, how you can participate, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research in Ocala, 352-629-5800.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of Kinetic Motion Fitness here in Ocala, Florida. A lot of you have experienced our great classes and personal small group training, but did you know we now offer dynamic workouts on DVD? These high-quality, locally produced, effective DVD workouts can go where you go. Going on vacation? No problem. We can go with you. Friends and relatives out of town who are jealous that you get to come to KMF? No problem. We ship anywhere in the United States for free. Our great lineup of four DVDs includes Kinetic Achieve, Kinetic Couples, Kinetic Core, and Kinetic Campus. Four great workouts for the entire family on DVD. Sound interesting? Check them out on our website at kmfocala.com. While you're there, check out our class schedule and come see us. We're only 5 minutes from downtown across from the Skylark Plaza. Visit kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. KMF will get you results at our studio or at home with one of our DVDs. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are. Visit kmfocala.com for more information.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Jerry Ferris Finger, a journalist and editor retired from the Atlanta Journal-Constitution and coming up to speak to us about the book The Devil Laughed, a Mariah Drew Richard Lake mystery novel.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events served bite-sized.
And then Hank Whittier will be in the studio bringing you veterans news as he does each and every Thursday.
August Turek is the founder of Raleigh Group International and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal, Forbes, and Business Week. He's written a book called Business Secrets of the Monks, one CEO's quest for meaning and authenticity.
And then Linda Gygax, Susan Smith, Nancy Porter, and Lois Lane will be in the studio talking to us about the 2013 charity fundraising event.
Melanie Gideon and Staff Sergeant Brian Schieffer will be on the phone. They will be speaking about the UCLA Operation Mend, helping heal America's wounded warriors.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Oh, Calibre. Hi, this is John Sotomayor, executive editor of Ocala Magazine, here to tell you that Ocala Magazine now has its very own radio show, and it's right here on WOCA The Source.
Tune in every Friday at 10 a.m.
And we bring the pages of Ocala Magazine to life. We'll be covering the latest stories that impact your world right here in Ocala.
Be sure to tune in every Friday at 10 a.m.
for Ocala Magazine Radio, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Hey, welcome back to Buddy Sports Page. Interesting story that really isn't being talked about today because it's Johnny Manziel Day. Of course, Manziel receiving that death sentence, half a game suspension against Rice for his part in the deal, and an obvious plea bargain. I read the story. I still haven't figured out exactly what they did. We don't know yet. They're very closed mouth. But an interesting story is the Tim Tebow start. And it's particularly interesting because you guys have never been around Tebow, okay? I spent 4 years around him being a good bit, where he was interviewed, you know, 2 and 3 times a week and before and after games, whatever. And I can say, I knew Tim Tebow, interviewed Tim Tebow, actually had dinner with Tim Tebow. I'm not a personal friend of Tim Tebow, but I respect and admire him, what he's done, and I root for him. I root for him because he's a good person. And my wife has often said, and she's probably right, that the greatest thing that Tim Tebow will do will be outside of football, which, by the way, is exactly what Craig Damon preaches at North Marion, which is one of the reasons that he's going to become the head of the Florida High School Activities Association, leaving North Marion High School. And he tells his players, use football for a higher task, for something that you really can do to change the world. So I think Tim Tebow will have – I think my wife's right. I think Tim Tebow's impact is yet to be felt. I think his missions and things he's done abroad and other things will be even bigger. I can't tell you how extremely popular Tebow is. And it's a different kind of popper than Johnny Manziel. Johnny Manziel has the pop culture thing going. He's got all that going on. He's white hot. He's the most famous celebrity, quote unquote, which he's consuming him, by the way, in the history of college football. I can't believe I'm saying that, because I've known a lot of big names in the game, but he's one of those, because of social media, he's become a phenomenon. So he's a different kind of popular. Tim Tebow has a lasting and more meaningful impact on people because of his deep spiritual values and the fact that people admire the kind of person he is. We sit there and talk about Manziel, and of course, he's a player in both on and off the field. He likes to party and whatever. Tim Tebow, of course, is a straight-laced guy. He's a Christian. He's got certain values he lives by. But there's so many people who value Tebow as a person and as an impact on life. And I'm a little distracted by the guy walking on those shoes, by the way, those stilts out there. Looks like, who's the guy who, Oscar, what's his name, who's in the murder trial over in, who has the feet.
Oscar Pistorius.
That's what it looked like for a minute. Those shoes on the guy had some kind of stilts. Anyway, back to Tebow. Here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking this morning, you know, there are an awful lot of people who I'm sure are going to tell Robert Kraft, please, if you possibly can, will you get Tim Tebow, keep him on the team. Lo and behold, I pick up the ESPN today, and here's a story. It says, New England Patriots owner Robert Kraft said Tuesday he is rooting for, quote-unquote, quarterback Tim Tebow to make the 53-man roster, but said the decision is up to Bill Belichick. I'm rooting for him, big time, Kraft said. So it's on the record. The owner of the team is rooting. So if there's an opportunity for him to make the squad, if it's a coin flip, I think Tebow's got a good person in his corner. Meanwhile, we caught up with Mark Long of the AP now. I believe Mark's ready. Hi, Mark. How you doing?
Hey, buddy. Doing well. Sorry about that.
Well, you have these story things called stories that come up, don't they?
Yeah, occasionally. But in this case, I just had my phone on silent for whatever reason.
So, there you go. The old silent phone deal. I know about
that's
that.
That's right.
Well, anyway, thanks for joining us, Mark, and we'll get right to it because we're coming up against a break. I want to get your take real quick on this Gator football team that ticks it off against Toledo on Saturday. And I know we can't tell too much, but something tells me, although I'm not terribly optimistic about any championships here, something tells me this team might be a little better than what we might give them me credit for. What's your take on that?
Well, you know, I don't know. I just think offensively they've got some weapons, but, you know, who knows what's going to happen against there. You're talking about Toledo's offense, right?
Well, Toledo's – no, I'm talking about Florida's offense. I'm talking about Florida's team.
Oh, sorry.
Florida as a team.
Yeah,
Florida as a team might be better overall than what we think they are.
I don't know about that. But, I mean, better than people say,
yes.
Probably. But, I mean, listen, buddy, this is a top-10 team. They're ranked number 10 in the country. So, they're getting a ton of respect from the writers. They're getting a ton of respect from the coaches. I think 10, even though that's third in the East, I think ranked 10th in the country is pretty high for this team, given what they've lost on defense, given that, you know, when you look at offensively, they were the 104th overall offense in the country last year, 114th in passing, and they still don't really have that dynamic playmaker, proven playmaker on offense. And again, you're replacing Mike Gillisley, a 1,000-yard rusher. You lose Frankie Hammond, you lose Jordan Reed, your leading receiver. There's a lot of missing pieces on offense, and then even more on the defensive side of the ball when you're talking about Elam and Bosick and Jelani Jenkins and defensive line-wise, you lost a lot with Lorente McCray and Sharif Boyd, obviously the best player on defense all last season. So all of a sudden, you know, I look at this team and I see a lot of question marks, and I think that they're been given a lot of credit going into this season based on, you know, based on what they've lost. Now then, with that said, do I think they could be better? Absolutely. I think, you know, if they're not better on offense, then you got some real issues there. And defensively, I think that some of the guys who are going to, you know, who are stepping into starting roles are going to be really special. You know, and it starts, you know, Antonio Morrison's one of them. And that defensive line with Bullard and Fowler, I think they've got a real chance to be special.
Yeah, Morrison, of course, today talks to the media. I apologize. What I want to get back to is this, and you're right about this, about the respect, but there's just this one thing that when we sat down to ask the question Tuesday about who could win the SEC East, the first impulse is to say South Carolina, or second, Georgia. That's what I want to say. But there's a little something inside of me saying, do you really know what this team is about? Because I don't. I have not seen them. And I know that they got an offensive line. They got a terrific running back prospect. They've got a quarterback who should be better, an offensive coordinator. And they got some freshman receivers who are starting to show up. Their defense could be lights out. And so I'm thinking, do I really know enough to eliminate them from the SEC East? And I've tended to do that ever since their Sugar Bowl loss. I've tended to downplay them. I'm just being honest.
Right.
I'm thinking, am I really being fair here? Because this team may be a whole lot better than what I know. So I'm just checking myself to say, have I missed something or what?
No, you're right, and nobody really knows because again, three open practices. You know, just aren't really, you know, that's not enough to really gauge where this team's going to be at offensively and defensively. And again, like you said, all of a sudden, some of the open practices, they were missing one of their better defenders in Antonio Morrison, and they certainly have been missing their if not the best, certainly one of the top two or three offensive players in Matt Jones. And again, good news this week is Matt Jones is going to be back and ready for week two against Miami, and that's going to be huge because this is, you know, no matter what you say, this is, you know, or whoever they add as freshman or whatever, the bottom line is this team's got to be able to run the ball to be successful. That's who they are. That's their identity. They're this grind it out, wear you down kind of offense, and it's going to start and end with Matt Jones.
We're speaking with Mark Long of the Associated Press. Mark, Tom Schmitz here. We've went this long to the interview, and I guess I'm going to have to ask the question. 30 minutes against Rice. That's the suspension handed down to Johnny Manziel. Should the NCAA even handed down the suspension if this was going to be the suspension they handed down?
Yeah, I mean, I know exactly where you're coming from, Tom. I think the NCAA didn't have any evidence, and they took the lightest, basically, approach that they could take realistically, and that's, you know, one half. And I'm sure, you know, I'm sure they looked at it and looked back at the Cam Newton situation, and there was a guy who, you know, by all accounts did worse because they had proof that he took, that his father took money, and he didn't get suspended for anything. So in this case, I just don't know, you know, it's all about what you can prove and not what you think. And in this case, if these people weren't giving the NCAA these, you know, showing the NCAA these records of Johnny Manziel taking money or these videos of Johnny Manziel taking money or acknowledging that he was getting paid and all that stuff, the stuff that ESPN supposedly had, you know, then it's real hard to go ahead and, you know, drop the hammer on this guy. You would end up losing in court or on appeals process or whatever, and then you look, you know, and then you end up looking like you do in the Miami case, where you just look bad. And the NCAA's had enough bad raps right now; they probably didn't need another one.
All right, real quick, Mark, have you heard about the Rolling Stone story that's out there someplace about Aaron Hernandez?
I read it today. Yeah,
and it kind of tries to implicate Urban Meyer for covering up, you know, a drug suspension. My question is, since an independent group actually does the drug testing, how can a coach cover it up? It really isn't his decision whether or not the guy has had a drug, you know, fails a drug test. So what did you get from that?
Yeah, I agree with you. I still think that's one of the things that Florida has stuck to from day one, that, you know, they've been real clear that, you know, you're not going to find five or six drug tests, failed drug tests, like people have been talking about. And I have a hard time believing Florida from the top on down would stick to that story and be so adamant about it being that you know, being only one failed drug test that, you know, if there was any proof in it. So I really think the story to me was kind of much ado about nothing. They put some teasers out there yesterday, and they really kind of fell short of meeting those teasers. Yeah. And the reality is the Boston Herald writer, who's been covering the story for the Boston Herald since day one here, co-authored the thing. So a lot of it was rehashed from what's been in the papers and been out there. Yeah. I think there was, you know, certainly the PCP use, the angel dust was new, and there was a couple of mild revelations in there, maybe some detail. But as far as, you know, anything that's what I would consider earth-shattering or case-breaking or whatever, I thought it definitely fell short.
Yeah, you can say what you want about Jeremy Foley. You love him or hate him, and you can say what you want about Urban Meyer. Jeremy Foley is not going to cover something up. He came from a culture that did that once, and he was the guy who had to take the stern of the ship and straighten it out. Foley's not going to live that
way. Especially with a coach who's no longer here.
Right.
You know, it'd be one thing if he's still your head coach and maybe you're protecting him or whatever, but the guy's gone. The guy's been gone now for 3 years. There's no reason to hide and cover that up.
Exactly. Okay, I'll see you in the press box on Saturday, where Florida is a 24-point favorite against Toledo, and you'll see how that comes out. Which side do you want, by the way? You taking the Gators?
I would take the Gators minus 24 in this. I just don't think Toledo will be able to score.
Mark Long, Associated Press. Thanks, Mark. Glad we caught up.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks, buddy.
Take a break, and we'll come back and wrap things up here on Buddy Sports Page on Wednesday afternoon right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Wowzers! July sales were unusually great and we weren't prepared for it. Now we need cars quick to restock our lot.
Hey, this is Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I've cooked up a crazy idea that can help you stop driving a car you hate and help me get cars now.
It's a car bazaar. It's weird, wild, and worth the trip.
It's more fun than a flea market.
And there are more deals than a dollar store. So bring that old car you hate driving to our car bazaar.
Even if you owe way more than it's worth?
Yes, and get a lot more than appraised value.
Even if your credit is good or bad?
Yes, with our For the People credit approval process, we want to help you stop driving a car you hate today.
The bazaar ends after we've helped 37 people find a car they love. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige!
WOCA. Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah. whatsupocala.com.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA The Source.
Call me crazy. Some people say insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. I think insanity is 1,000 single-sided, full-color business cards for $15, or packing service for 50% off. Call me crazy. Regency Printing, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street, 789-6683. That's 789-6683. Look for the yellow signs.
Back on the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports page. This Rex Ryan playing Mark Sanchez story isn't going to go away anytime soon. And now Jets golden boy Joe Namath has weighed in on it. He was in talk to Rich Eisen today, and